Hey gang, this is John Newton, and I'm back for part two of the series of Bodril fire creation from wood selection all the way to flame. And behind me is one of the softwoods that I haven't tried yet, but I'm going to, and it is staghorn sumac. And I'll show you. Very common, and it's right here. And what you'll recognize probably is the red clusters of, I guess, berries. There's another one right there. I don't know if you can see it. And it's got pinnately compound leaves. And one of the ways you can tell it's staghorn sumac is the when you feel, like right there, that branch is covered in fine hairs, so it feels like a deer buck in velvet. That's where it gets its name, is staghorn. And so, get a little farther back. There's a better picture of it. And it's technically a tree, I guess, but it doesn't grow very tall. But it's everywhere. You'll see it along the highways and stuff when you're driving. What I'm gonna do, so that I don't forget any, I wrote down some softwoods, and some of them we're gonna see, some of them we're not going to. Yucca stalks, I have some of those, but I got those when I was traveling out west and visiting with Dave Wendell from Bushcraft on Fire. Yucca stalks are one of the best spindle materials around, and it said, when I looked it up, it said that the ignition point is only 200 degrees Fahrenheit, and that's the lowest of anything, so that's probably why they're so good. But the other is cottonwood, cedar, eastern white cedar, aspen, basswood, of course, staghorn sumac, willow, black or weeping, the poplars, there's yellow and white. Yellow is the one that's the tulip poplar. That's the one I showed you in the last video. Box elder maple, I showed you that last night, and I collected a piece of box elder maple. Sycamore, mullein stalk, that's a weed. We'll probably see some of that out here. If we don't, I know where there's some by my house. Wild grape and honeysuckle. So I'm going to show you willow and anything else that we just happen on while I'm out today. And then the next video, I'm going to start processing some of the materials I've collected. Also, if I run into any tinder material, I'm going to collect that and show you, because that's part of it. Because what I'd like to do, I want to make this as realistic as possible, just like you're right here with me and I'm teaching you how to create a fire. So I'm going to show you materials for bird's nest, and I'm going to show you the different materials for tinder also as I find it. Also, this, I'm going to use this video series for my scout troop too. Here's a better picture of staghorn sumac. I forgot to mention, one of the easiest ways to tell is it's one of the first things to turn in the fall, and it's bright red. But as you can see, the clusters, what's nice about them is they're real sour because they contain a bunch of acids, and so you can mix those with water and make a really good tasting lemonade. Here are some aspens. This is one right here. There's one there. It's the one that's got the bark that looks like it's kind of gray with white on it. Right there. And actually, if you look, I don't want to go into the sun. There's, maybe I can do it over here. But you see how it always looked to me, it looks like a white birch because they're so light colored. So
when they're younger, they've got a light gray, whitish gray appearance, and towards the top they almost look like a birch. They're so light. But that's what an aspen looks like. And the leaves are well, here's some leaves from one. This is perfect timing. It's a quaking aspen. As you see, the leaves are really long. The stems are super long. It's got a rounded back. It's not flat. Well, if you get a really one that's real wide and flat across the back, that's a cottonwood. But these are real long, thin stems, and when the wind blows, it makes the leaves flutter back and forth. That's the quaking aspen part. So they're sort of heart-shaped. Give you a picture of one. So that's one, that's an aspen. That's one of the trees I haven't tried. And they're right next to me. That's an aspen. And as you go up, they get lighter and lighter, but if you look up that way, it almost looks like you're looking up into some white birch. But those are aspens, and I have not tried them. So the list I came up with was, I went online just to make sure I didn't miss anything. And so I went to several different resources and picked up the list. So what I'll tell you while I'm walking is the ones I've tried are cottonwood and cedar and basswood and willow and poplar. I've not tried wild grape, can't wait to try. And honeysuckle, I've never tried that. That's almost like a vine, but you can find big ones. And so I'm gonna be doing some experimenting, and I'll let you know what the results are of those too. All right, just a gorgeous day. Not really a cloud in the sky, but I've still got a time crunch. And so I'm just exercising, like I said before, I'm exercising, and I thought I would do this instead of trying to, in little segments, instead of trying to cram a whole bunch of stuff in to where 80% of it was in the dark and you didn't really get to see it well. So I'm going to be doing the processing maybe even in different locations where it doesn't have any bearing on where you're going to be. There's some grapevine. What I'm looking for is, it goes up here, it goes around that right there. What I'm looking for is giant, huge grapevines that where there's some dead ones. And then I'm gonna get my saw out and cut a piece. So today I'm gonna collect some grapevine and any other thing I can find. I already have the box elder. I haven't seen any cottonwood, but there's cottonwood by my house. So what I suggest is, if you're really interested in this, is to get a book on trees. Peterson's got a good one. Audubon's is pretty good. And just write down the names of the trees that I've given you. These are the soft things. And see if you can go out and identify them. And then maybe even look at the hard ones so that you know what to stay away from. But once I said before, the big test, if you don't know what the wood is to try to sink your thumbnail in it and make a mark. And if you can make a little mark in it with your thumbnail, it's soft enough. If anybody knows differently, let me know if this isn't bear scat, because it looks too big to be a coyote, and it's full of hair, and I knocked it with my foot, and there's a bunch of it down here on the ground, right there where that stick is. So it was a large, giant pile. My hand for reference. Just happened to notice that, and somebody had told me that they've been finding a lot of bear scat along the trail, but nobody's seen any bears. That'd be cool if we saw a bear. I will definitely make sure I turn my camera on if I have time. It doesn't run too fast. But because I'm stopping and talking, probably won't see much. I've seen some squirrels and I've seen a few deer, but before I could do anything, they were gone. See, if you want to be able to identify things, this tree's got that shaggy appearance. There's another one. You see the shagginess. It's not shaggy like a shag bark, but it's hairy looking. That is the hop hornbeam, and that's super hardwood. That's related to the birch. And that's so hard to use it for making handles and stuff, because it doesn't grow real big. I'm going to save the going through the field and as I sweep through for last, because the woods will get darker than the field will. So just up ahead, we're going to see some willow. I know where that is, and then I know there's some a bunch of grapevines, so we'll go over there and see what we can collect. All right, I want people to PM me if they can tell me what leaf this is from. Here's my hand. It's toothed. It's got an uneven backside. Not sure what they call that, but okay. And the tree is got gray bark. Another close-up of the leaves. It's just a little question for you. Talk about a death grip. Look at that thing. Stay with me to walk out here, because there's a willow right here. This is a black willow. And if anybody has a correction, since I'm not infallible, I'm thinking this is a black willow just because there's almost no white willows around at all. But you can tell the willows because they have lancet-shaped leaves. And once I show them to you, they're long. Here. Long, like a spear point. Okay? They also are toothed. And this is black willow. And you could actually cut one of these long straight branches and then use that for a spindle. You'd have to let it dry a little bit. And there's the willow tree. Black willow's got multiple stumps, or multiple trunks usually, and a lot of times it's leaning. That's one of the problems with willow for me, is it's hard to find any with straight grain. There's one out of reach that's straight as a die, right there, which would make a great, it's dead even, so it would make a great hearth board and spindle, but of course I can't get to it. So, if, and that's the thing too, is I'm not gonna do every single wood. So, I just know that willow is good. I've tried willow, and it's pretty easy to be successful. Right here is a walnut. You can see the walnuts right there, and it has pinnately compound leaves, but it's one that you want to stay away from. The nuts are delicious. It's black walnut, but the wood is real hard. That's another thing, is you might want to learn a lot of the ones that are hard, so you know which ones to stay away from, like oak, maple, except for box elder maple, of course. The ironwoods, a lot of the fruit trees, I think, are hard, like cherry. Birch is hard. So you want to just try to stay away from some of those. Down in here is where we're going to find some good grapevines that are large. The tree that looks like it's got burnt corn chip for bark is a black cherry. And here's a big piece of grapevine. But I want to try to find a dead one, if at all possible. That way I don't have to let it sit for any length of time. But I can tell you, the soft woods like basswood, I have not tried. Oh, yes, I did. One time I tried cutting it and using it immediately, and I found that it just kind of burnished. It didn't really heat up much. But you can cut basswood, split it up, and use it within a few days. Like if you have a hearth board that's like an inch thick, which I'm going to give you dimensions of what I like to use. And that's one thing, is a hearth board. I like it to be about an inch thick and 2 to 3 inches wide, so that I can, sometimes you can use one side or the other. And I like it flat, and I like the sides squared off too. I want to find one that's got a straight section and about as big around as my wrist. There's a bunch here. Let's see. See, this bark flakes off. That's the part I told you before, is real good for the backing of your bird's nest, the base. It's stiff enough, and it's real flammable, but it's not so flammable that it takes a spark very easily, and you can't process it down enough to do it, because it crumbles into nothing. When you're trying to find something that'll work well for taking a spark, like cedar, when you process it down, as you get it smaller and smaller, if it stays together almost like tobacco, that's what you're looking for. Now we're starting to see cedars. I did find an old piece of grapevine, so I cut that. And the cool thing about cedar, you can use, I love using cedar for bow drill sets, but my favorite thing is the bark. This is an eastern white cedar, and the bark is, you scrape that bark with the back of your knife or some 90 degree angle implement that's like a sharp 90 degree angle, and you can scrape that down and get some fluff. What I'm looking for is a piece of cedar that is dead, that kind of split out, like maybe this one. This piece right here. Let me see what it looks like close up. It might be a little too pithy. But it's just about perfect. I'll see if I can find another one. This is what I'm looking for. See how that's split off? So I snagged a piece of it. When you find one like that, then it's halfway processed for you. So you're always trying to conserve your resources. But all these beautiful trees in here are eastern white cedar. And they don't, they're not resinous. This is my opinion, but I don't like any of the pines because they have resin in them and they end up burnishing. See, this is another one right there that's split off that you could probably collect some. Actually, that long piece right there is the piece, but up in there some you can easily take. I just paused here just to show you how beautiful it is. Cedar in the foreground and a gorgeous stream that's just slowly going. There, you can see that it's water. There you go. Now you can actually see into the water. Incredibly, it was so dark in the woods that I was going to have to get a flashlight out to see so I wouldn't keep stumbling over roots and stuff. Now we're looking for tender. I was able to find, I'll put it on the ground. That was a piece that was split from a wind storm or something. That piece right there, cedar also, I cut that off of a tree that actually broke off and blew over. And then here's the big piece of grapevine. So now that I've got those collected, I'm going to try to find some what I call flash tender, which is the fluffy stuff that you have to mix with other things because it literally flashes and burns out before it ignites anything else. So hopefully I'll find some before it gets dark out here too. I just had to show you that sky. I hope it shows up. It's beautiful red streaks. Also, I'm gonna go ahead and sign off just in case it gets too dark and I don't find anything else, because the last video I realized I didn't even sign off because it got so dark. So if you like this series, please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and I'd love to get your comments
And don't forget that one leaf. Let me know, first person that is able to message me with the correct answer is going to get a surprise. Well, until we meet again, God bless.